is Ross Arena, and I am professor and head of the Department of Physical Therapy at the University of Illinois Chicago. I'm very pleased to introduce one of our latest scientific statements from the AHA discussing supervision of exercise testing by non-physician health professionals. Just a little bit of background about my history with this paper. At its inception, I was chair of the Clinical Cardiology Exercise Cardiac Rehab and Secondary Prevention Committee within AHA and was clearly an advocate for this paper. And I'd like to congratulate John Myers and Dan Foreman for leading this writing group, and they've done a wonderful job. And so why we thought this paper was very important is clearly exercise testing in a number of patient populations is highly valuable from a prognostic and diagnostic standpoint, also with gauging functional capacity, the potential for disability, and exercise prescription, as we're gaining an appreciation more and more every day that exercise truly is medicine, and AHA is certainly championing that message with other professional organizations such as ACSM. So history with respect to exercise testing is that the physician role within the exercise testing environment, the clinical laboratory, has somewhat evolved over the last several decades where physicians don't directly administer the tests at this point anymore on a regular basis. They typically rely on non-physician health professionals. A host of them can fit that role, such as nurse practitioners, exercise physiologists, physical therapists, and so on. But there really was a gap in the literature or in the HA statements with respect to who is appropriate to administer such tests and what their competencies should be, what their experience level should be, and so on. So this document really tried to address that. So defining the core competencies of the non-physician professional that administers the exercise test. The statement by no means is a way to distance the exercise testing environment from the physician. In fact, we strongly feel and voice it throughout the paper that the physician is still the person, the individual who oversees the exercise testing laboratory. But the physician, we wanted to give the physician that oversees that laboratory some guidance on competencies for the non-physician professionals that typically administer the test. Another key point within the paper is with respect to the level of supervision the physician should provide or feel comfortable with. So either being directly in the room, immediately available within close proximity, or perhaps at a further distance where they can quickly make their way to the exercise testing environment if there is an emergency situation. And that is all somewhat dependent upon the level of risk at baseline that of the individual being tested. So that is another big component of the paper is kind of defining the logistics of that. Other key pieces of this document is to discuss what the roles and responsibilities of the non-physician professional should be with respect to selecting an appropriate exercise test protocol, their knowledge of calibrating equipment, their knowledge of interpreting a test, and so on and so forth. So we're really excited that this document can serve several roles and be a guiding piece of the literature with respect to who should or who is appropriately trained to administer exercise tests in the clinical environment. We do feel that this has a tremendous value for patient populations that receive exercise testing in the sense that the caliber of individuals administering the tests and the data that is gathered from such tests will be of high caliber. We really hope that you enjoy this document, so physicians and non-physicians alike, and really find it valuable in the clinical exercise testing environments and really helps to guide practice in that environment. Thank you very much.